Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the Bare Necessities Index. So basically, this is the one which has been recently announced by the Economic Survey. So you must have been aware that before the budget, so today the budget was also tabled on House. Before the budget, the Economic Survey is also issued. So in that regard, in this particular video, we will discuss a new kind of index which has been issued by the Bare Necessity Index by the Economic Survey. So this is going to be the context. We will look into what exactly is Bare Necessity Index and how the Economic Survey is trying to gauge what is the minimum or the bare necessity across the rural and urban areas. So let's start. Economic Survey 2020-21, which is the recent one which has been launched, construct a bare necessity index at the rural, urban and all India level. So it is a study which has been conducted at rural, urban as well as all India level. So all three components are included. It aims to assess equity. Economic Survey introduced Bare Necessities Index. So the idea for which this particular index was introduced in order to assess the equity, like how the equity has been across the rural and urban as well as at all India level. Inequalities in cases to bare necessities like drinking water, sanitation, hygiene and housing condition continue to exist between the urban and rural India. Despite widespread improvement in each of these aspects, the Economic Survey 2020-21 has shown using a newly constructed Bare Necessity Index. So what this basically means that even though there has been an improvement, so if there is a question which says that there has been improvement in case of the reduction in inequalities, not in terms of weight, but we are talking about reduction in inequalities in terms of the housing, for an example, sanitation, hygiene, drinking water. In that case, there has been an increase in reduction in inequalities, and that has been reserved by the BNI, Bare Necessities Index. But at the same time, even though there is a reduction, it could mean that it does not mean that there is no way that you can go ahead and carry on with the status quo, in essentially, which means that it's more along the line that what is going to happen. Even though there is a reduction, it does not mean inequality doesn't exist. So there is still inequality. The BNI builds on the idea of Thali Economics, which was in Economic Survey the previous year, through which it had sought to examine the excess of food in the country. So Thalinomics, it was the one which has been introduced in the last Economic Survey. So if you go through the Economic Survey of 2019-2020, you would realize there is a term called Thali Economics, which was more along the line how the food has become affordable to the people and how is the accessibility regarding to food. This time the Bare Necessity Index take it further, and we are talking about how the inequalities exist in case of drinking water, sanitation, hygiene, water supply. So this is something you should keep in mind. Now let's just quickly see some features of it. So BNI summarizes 26 indicators. So how many indicators? There are around 26 indicators which are going to function along the five dimensions, which include water, sanitation, housing, micro environment and other facilities that has been created for all state for 2012 and 2018. So basically, national sample organization data has been used to figure out the data from 2012 and 2018, and there are five dimensions which has been checked. What are those? They include your water, sanitation, then your housing, micro environment, how the situation at the micro level is, and the some other facilities also. So these are the one which has been checked. So the index classifies areas on three level of access: high, medium and low to bare necessity. Like the area which have good access to the bare necessity would be high, and the one which does not have good accessibility would be low. So this is high, medium and low. That is how it has been divided. The BNI has created for all state for 2012 and 18. So these are the two base years. 2012 and 2018 are the years which have been chosen for the what you can say, comparison. Drinking water, sanitation, hygiene, and housing condition. So these are the water, sanitation, hygiene, and housing condition are the parameters on which the 2012 and 2018 data are compared. In most of the state, access to bare necessity for household has significantly increased. So this is again something from 2012 to 2018. Affordable housing has been improved. Again, access to drinking water to household in most of the state has also improved in the time period. So this is again something which is there. Now a very related schemes for both of these factor is for household we have PM Awas Yojana. So that is the one which aims at providing the affordable household in rural as well as urban areas. Along with the same line for drinking water, we have the Jal Jeevan Mission, which aims to provide ghar ghar jal. So in that case, you can understand both of these are component schemes which kind of have started showing result, and you can see from the data comparison that the improvement could be accessed. Other features like regional disparity in access to sanitation has declined, as the state having low access to sanitation in 2012 have gained more. So again, the regional disparity, what do you mean by regional disparity, is like some state like Maharashtra, Karnataka, they would have better access as compared to Bihar, Uttar Pradesh. So that kind of regional disparity used to exist, but this now gap is filling. Again, a major reason for this could be go to the Swachh Bharat Mission, which is working towards the better sanitation condition. Survey observe improvement in housing index, also indicating improvement in access to housing and reduction in interstate disparities, with disproportionate benefit for the lowest income in 2018 vis-a-vis 2012. Again, you could understand it as the effect of Awas Yojana. The economic survey also notes improvement in micro environment of all state in 2018, except for Assam in rural and Odisha and Assam in urban areas as compared to 2012. Again, for micro environment parameter also, you can see in the BNI that there has been an improvement. Survey also point to a positive correlation between access to bare necessities and better health and education outcome. Now, this is important. Whichever state has better BNI, it is directly correlated that that particular state is performing better on the human development in case of education as well as health. So you can understand that once the bare necessities are tackled with, it also have a positive correlation towards the education and healthcare also. It observes improvement in child survival, decline in stillbirths, malnutrition and infant mortality with improved access to sanitation and clean drinking water. So this is again, there is a positive correlation. So if you look at the map now, this is something which has been highlighted by the economic survey this year, that the BNI, the bare necessity index, which was for 2012, you can see the score which is less than 50. So you see a major chunk, a lot of states in India were in the factor of only 50%. They were below 50%, which means it was low. So low was the bare necessity index. They were performing poorly. And you see over here only few, like Goa was the one which was actually, and Delhi over here was the one which was having the better results. But look at the figure in 2018. Now this has been shrunk to only this area. So this is the only one which is now showing the below, low, medium in case of the bare necessity index. While at the other hand, the above 70 has also increased. So you see over here, Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand, Gujarat, Goa, Kerala, all these have been, even here in Sikkim, also in case of the Mizoram, you can see all these states have actually come up to an state where the basic bare necessities index, or you can understand it as the accessibility to housing, accessibility to drinking water, accessibility to sanitation and hygiene has improved. So this is something which has been highlighted. Again, you can just point it out what is BNI, and you can keep on track of this particular map. You can keep in mind, this will help you while writing the mains answer. So So I hope you have understood this video. There are many other topics which has been highlighted by Economic Survey. As and when they come into some article, some news, they become important. As the analysis of them comes out, we will be discussing about them in the future videos. So if you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.